cryptocurrency roller coaster never fails to provide a thrilling ride. This is a week in security by ESET. Keep listening to find out more. On Tuesday, the 9th of January, a tweet from the official US Securities and Exchange Commission X/Twitter account posted that the SEC now approved Bitcoin ETFs, resulting in the price of Bitcoin increasing to a 19-month high. The increase was short-lived, though. The chair of the SEC quickly posted on his own account that the SEC X account had been hijacked and the post was false. Now, the original false post was well-crafted and very believable, and likely the result of a SIM-swapping attack resulting in a hacker taking control of a phone number linked to the X account. According to reports from X, the account was not protected by two-factor or multi-factor authentication. Now, wow, there's a lot going on here, isn't there? The hacker may well have made money off the false post by inflating the price of Bitcoin. The SEC X account not being protected correctly is a huge embarrassment. I mean, and the SIM account on the phone should have been protected with a PIN at the carrier. And then in a bizarre twist, the next day, the SEC announced official approval of Bitcoin ETFs. Now, this has been a long-standing discussion and begs the question whether the hack forced the decision to squash any market volatility. So what is an ETF? It stands for Exchange Traded Fund. It means that investors can trade in funds that have multiple assets in them, and in this case may include Bitcoin. Now, some funds already include Bitcoin. What this actually approves is on-the-spot price trading. The lack of multi-factor authentication on an official account that can cause market volatility is baffling, and I'm being really polite here. All accounts should be using multi-factor authentication via an app-based authenticator, such as Google or Microsoft Authenticator. This removes the risk of SIM hijacking as it avoids the SMS carrier service, and the result is that it secures the account you're trying to protect. And please, if you've not already done so, contact your carrier and add a PIN to your carrier-based account and block SIM reissuing attempts. The other issue that this highlights for me is the need for vendors such as X to enable multi-factor authentication by default, or as a minimum SMS-based two-factor authentication. Why is it possible at all to have a social media account that does not require this additional layer of authentication? X, this should be on by default. Check out welivesecurity.com for more cybersecurity news. Stay safe, stay healthy, and be sure to watch our next video.